I stopped listing altogether on a platform in the month of January, so that had a little bit of an impact on my overall sales. We'll talk a lot more about that later. And also, with a baby right around the corner, I am going to have to pump the brakes for a few months. So I'll also be sharing how I plan to manage as I adjust to the many changes happening in my life. But first, let's get into the good and the bad sales of the month, the final numbers, and total profits as well. Starting off with the 8 high price sales of the month. The first one was on eBay, and for once, it's not a pair of shoes or a pair of boots. We have a purse. It was this Coach perforated large coral leather tassel detail duffel purse. It sold for full price at $135. My earnings after shipping and fees and everything was $107, and this bag was listed for 17 days. I have my average cost of goods for this purse listed at $909, but I remember that it was more like $25 to $30 that I paid for this purse. Normally with Michael Kors and Coach purses, I like to stick to those that have the all over monogram logo, but this one looked a little bit interesting because it was perforated, the color was beautiful, and it had those tassel tie details on the side. So I decided to go ahead and do comps to see if it was doing good online. It was so easy to do with that Google Lens app. Since the bag was a unique color, not just a plain brown or black, it brought up the exact style of the bag, and I was able to compare prices on eBay and Poshmark. It seemed to be doing really good and it didn't disappoint. Again, on eBay, number 7 was these Cabela's green leather lace-up combat boots. They were size 10 double E, which I think means extra wide, and they were men's. They sold for $80 and earnings was $62. This one was only listed for one day, so high profitable and fast sell too. Cabela's is not normally a brand I like to pick up. I've had bad experiences with their clothing in the past where it either sat for too long or sold for very little, but this style of boot is a definite pickup, a good style to be on the lookout for, and because the boots were almost like new, I paid $15 for them, a little bit on the higher end, but I was very confident that I'd make my money back and more because of the style of the boot. Next up, we have some more men's boots, this time on Poshmark. There were these Justin embroidered black leather distressed Western boots. These sold for $77. Earnings was $61.60, and these were listed for 46 days. So these did stick around for a little bit over a month, but still not a bad time frame for some Western boots that sell for this high. When it comes to Justin Western boots, this is the kind of style I like to be on the lookout for. When it has embroidery and just something extra unique going on, the crackle leather, distressed leather, but when they're just that plain brown or plain black, I leave them behind most of the time unless I can get them for very cheap and they're a really good size. Next one was a very surprising one to me. It was these Donna Karen New York equestrian thigh high velvet boots. They sold on Poshmark for $75. My earnings was $60, and these very tall boots were listed for 24 days. These I was kind of going back and forth with whether I should pick up or not. The bottom soles did have stickers on the brand name, so I couldn't really tell what the brand was. Sometimes it's hard to see in these super tall boots inside the insole to see the brand. So all I could see was the name Karen. So I thought it was something like Karen Kane or something cheap like that, that I've had bad experiences with selling clothing. So I just thought maybe it wasn't a good brand, but the soles did look high quality. There were only $5 and the boots were precious, so I thought I'll take the chance. It wasn't until I got home that I realized they were actually Donna Karan New York DKNY boots, and I was even more surprised when I saw the comps online. They were selling for pretty high amounts, and a lot of them were listed very high too. I ended up listing mine at $99, and then I accepted this $75 offer. I thought it was very reasonable, so I guess that could be a Bolo there. Thigh high DKNY boots, velvet boots, they can do really well. Likewise with this next brand, I was surprised. I'd never heard of it, and it ended up doing better than I expected. It was also on Poshmark, and they were called Thursday Boot Company. That was the brand name. These were some matte black leather slip-on Chelsea boots. They sold for $70. The earnings for these was $56. And these were listed for 9 days. I was aiming real high with these boots because I started the listing off at $110, just because that's what the comps were showing. But being that I only paid $10 for them, when I received this $70 offer, I decided to go ahead and accept it, just because, as I said, I don't have any experience with the brand. I'd never sold it before, and I just didn't want to take my chances having it sit for too long or end up selling for a lot less than that $70 offer. So that's why I took it. But I really hope I find more of that Thursday Boot Company brand boots in the future. The third one, on Mercari, we have these boots. They were the Durango suede leather western cowgirl mid-calf boots. These sold for $60. Earnings for these was $51.76, and these did sit for a little bit. The days listed was 70. I really thought these would sell a lot sooner, and I did get a bunch of low offers way before someone bought them on Mercari, but I declined and countered all of those offers because these boots were like new and I paid $25 for them, so I just wanted to hold off for the right buyer. Even though I know that Durango boots don't usually sell for that much unless they're embroidered or super embellished, the comps are pretty low on these Western boots compared to other Western boot brands. But as I said, being that they were like new and I paid up for them, I just wanted to hold off. And I think that was the right call in the end, even though they sat around for just a little bit longer. The next one is actually a coat instead of shoes this time. It was, where was this? On Poshmark. It was this Gary Black reflective hooded full zip ski coat. It sold in a bundle with these North Face boots right here. And it worked out that I got $59 for each of those items. Earnings was $47.20 for each, and the jacket was listed for a total of 32 days. I have listed that I paid an average cost of goods of $7.22 for this coat, but I want to say it was more in the $10 range. Gary is a brand that I'd never heard of, never picked up before, but the coat just looked durable, sturdy, and high quality. So after doing some comps, it seemed to be that Gary ski coats seemed to do pretty well, so that's why I decided to pick it up and give it a try. And in the end, it was a great return on investment. And by the way, the size charts that you see in the clothing and purse listings that I'm showing here on the screen are available for sale now. I will leave a link down in the description where you can click to. It'll take you to a Shopify page where you can learn more about them and kind of see how they work, and you can purchase if you'd like. Next high price sale was another surprising one actually, and it was also on Poshmark. It was these aerosol snake print wide strap block heel strappy sandals. They sold for $53. That was the surprising part. Earnings was $40.60, and the days listed for these sandals was 15 days. I skip a lot of aerosol when I'm outsourcing, but I will pick them up every now and again if the shoe is in great condition and if I can get it real cheap, like $3 or below. These here were a nice pattern. They were chunky. They just seem to be one of those kind of sandals that are going to be selling real quick when it comes to the summer. I did end up paying $5 for these, thinking that I would be able to flip them for $25, but when I went to list system and I saw the comps, I was extremely shocked at what they were listed and going for. I listed mine in line with the rest of those, and sure enough, they ended up selling at this very high price, which I think is kind of unheard of when it comes to aerosols. All right, let's move on to some low price sales of the month. In the past, low price sales weren't always a bad thing for me. If they left me a lower profit compared to other sales, it was okay. A lot of the items I would get just for the quick $10 to $12 flip, but my business model is changing a little bit because I am starting to delegate a lot of my reselling tasks, and I'm paying others to help me source, prep, take pictures, inventory, ship, and all of that. So I have to take all of that into consideration, and these lower profit sales is just not going to cut it anymore. What I'm looking for is a $15 final profit after cost of goods, platform fees, but $20 and up would be more ideal. All of that to say that all of the items I'm about to share with you in this low profit category are items that I would not pick up again moving forward. At least that's my stance on it right now. Starting off with the first one, it was an eBay sale, and it was this Knox Rose floral print lightweight smocked baby doll blouse. The total sale with shipping included was $19.83. I was left with $12.11 in earnings, and this top took a total of 99 days to sell. Knox Rose and plus size pieces used to be my bread and butter combo. I would pick that up all day long, but as of lately, they have been sitting a lot longer than they used to, so that's one reason why I'm not picking it up anymore. And the other is just, as I said, that's not the kind of profit I'm looking for anymore. Number seven was a Poshmark sale. It was these Lulu's lace-up strappy wedge sandals. These sold for $12 and the earnings was $9.05. These sandals took a total of 195 days to sell. Some Lulu shoes can sell pretty quickly for an okay profit, but I've had quite a few sit around for longer than I'd like. So unless I find something extra unique by this brand, no more Lulu shoes moving forward. Number six, a Mercari sale. Well, actually, this was on eBay. It was this torrid blue floral fit and flare plus size knee length dress. It sold for $15. Earnings here was $10.18, and it took a total of 77 days to sell. Torrid is another brand that used to be a bread and butter that I would just pick up for the quick $10 to $12 flip, but I am not picking up as much clothes as of lately. I'm trying to focus more on shoes, but if and when I do pick up clothes, it's not going to be Torrid. Unless it's something more noteworthy, like a long maxi dress, maybe some outerwear, a good denim coat. If it's not something like that, I'm going to leave it behind. But when it comes to Torrid shoes, those I'm still picking up, especially their boots, because they have a higher selling price. Number five, on Poshmark, we have these One State Gray Suede D'Orsay Flat Summer Sandals. They sold for $13. The earnings was $8.33, and I had these listed for a total of 289 days. These sandals are something that I would definitely not pick up again, more so because of condition. When I brought them home, I realized they had a lot more wear than I initially took note of. In the summer, I'm sure I'm going to start seeing a lot of sandals by this brand. If the condition is good and the price is good, I may still pick it up, especially if it's a very good style, but I'm going to be a lot more careful with looking at the overall condition of the sandals, because those sat around for that long because they weren't in that great of a shape. Number four, we have this Angie Wideleg floral smocked spaghetti strap jumpsuit that sold on eBay. It sold for a total of $14. Earnings was $11.63, and this one sold in 138 days. This is another item that sat around for way too long, most likely because of the condition. I didn't notice when I picked it up that one of the belt loops was loose. It was was unsewn, so it was going to need some work. I made note of that in the pictures and in the description, but likely that's why it took a while to sell. Angie makes beautiful bohemian style pieces. They're a great pickup, especially during the summer. Their rompers, jumpsuits, dresses, all of those can do pretty well. Well, they sell quick. The price point is more like $15 to $20. So if you can find them real cheap, I'd say it's a decent pickup. The third one on the list is on Poshmark, and it was these Guess Vintage Straight Leg Retro High-Rise Light Blue Wash Denim Jeans. They sold for $15, which left me with earnings of $12, and these took a total of 129 days to sell. Not really much to say about these here. It was just a terrible pickup. I thought because they were vintage, they would end up selling quick and for a decent profit, but I was wrong. That was just a terrible sale all around. Poshmark again, we have this Aussie Skiwear Wool Blend Pullover Sweater. It was red black knit and had a geometric print. This sold for $16, earnings was $12.80, and this one was listed for 78 days. Same like the last pair of jeans, this was a total style-based pickup. I thought the print was nice, it looked retro-ish, and it was just the season for it. It was wool blend. I thought it would end up doing okay, but it disappointed. I started off this sweater at $37. I saw that it was just sitting and sitting, so slowly I've been dropping the price, and in the end I ended up accepting the $16 offer. The next low price sale is another Poshmark sale, and it was this Orvis chenille, I'm not sure how you say that word, but it's that very soft velvety fabric. It was a pullover navy blue sweater. It sold for $16, which left me with earnings of $12.80. And this sweater took a total of 91 days to sell. Last winter, I sold a few of these Orvis sweaters and they ended up selling pretty quick. So come this winter, when I saw a bunch of them at the thrift store, it was like four or five of them, I picked them all up thinking they would end up doing just as good as last year. But I was so wrong. These have just been sitting and sitting. The only one that sold really fast, I think, was a size large or extra large. And the ones that I have left are smaller sizes. So I'm pretty sure I'm gonna end up keeping those till next winter. So I would say this style of sweater is one to avoid. Let's move on to some things that I would pick up again. Here are 8 fast sales of the month, starting off with an eBay one. It was these Angelo Morani red leather snake print western heeled boots. They sold for a total of $32. My earnings was $27.46, and these took just one day to sell. These I picked up totally based on style. I'd never heard of this brand before, and when I was trying to do comps, there really isn't that much information out there. But they were just too unique to leave behind. They had the whole watercolor look, they had wingtip in the front, a pointed toe, a little bit of a suede trim, some snake print. It had a lot of unique features, so I thought that it would do well. When I got home, I did realize that some laces that belonged on the back upper shaft were missing, so I thought that was going to affect them, that maybe they were going to sell for lower than I expected, or that they were going to sit around for a very long time. But I was wrong. Because they were so unique, they ended up selling for an okay price point and really quick too. Next one on the list is a Poshmark sale, and it was these Born Western knee-high brown soft leather equestrian riding boots. They sold for $42. Earnings there was $31.88, and these also sold in just one day. I've been doing pretty good with these kind of Born boots. Well, all sorts of Born boots, but these especially, they tend to sell for about $40 and up, and I can easily find them for anywhere from $5 to $8 at the thrift store. So that is a very profitable brand and style combo there. Look out for tall Western Born boots. they can do well. Same with this next brand. It was an eBay sale, and it was this fossil floral embroidered brown leather top handle medium size handbag. This one sold for $38. Earnings was $22.90, and it was also listed for just one day. I've picked up fossil bags in all sorts of conditions. Some with missing straps, stains, some that have slits in the leather, and still, they always end up selling pretty quickly. This fossil brand is a retro vintage one that has a strong following. So even if you see one that has some minor wear, and if you can get it at a decent price, I'd say pick it up. The ones that have the charms, the keychain charms, or are embroidered and are in more of good condition, those can sell for even more. But of course, when they do have a little bit of wear, they're gonna sell for a little bit less. This next old school style of shoe also has a strong following and can also do well even if the condition is not the best. It was a Poshmark sale. And it's these Nike Shox Lace Up Athletic White Silver Casual 2013 Retro Sneakers. These sold for a total of $40. Earnings was $32 and also sold in just one day. This is my second time finding this type of sneaker, and both times the shoes had some wear. The first time they had some paint splatters around the shoe, and still I think they sold for about $50. These here also, the bottom sole, the tread part was just so smooth. It wasn't in the best of condition. I made sure to clean it the best I could everywhere. The insoles, I took them off and scrubbed them down to get them looking in the best condition possible, but there's only so much you can do. These shoes weren't in the best of shape, and still they ended up selling. And because of the shape of the shoes at the thrift store, they were only priced like $7 or $8, when usually they will price up Nike athletic shoes to like $25 and up. So I was able to get these for cheap and able to flip them around for a pretty good amount. The next one was a Poshmark sale as well, and it's a brand to know called Olukai. They were jacquard black gray camel canvas slip-on comfort sneakers. They sold for a total of $36, and my earnings was $27.08. And again, these sold in just one day. Olukai is a brand that I enjoy finding. This is the first time I find sneakers by them though. In the past, I've only found sandals. During the summer, I like to look out for these because they always sell very quickly. So when you're in the shoe section, especially this summer, look out for this horseshoe logo because they sell quick and for decent amounts. Again on Poshmark, this next one is these Lucky Brand black soft leather casual ankle boots. They sold for a total of $32. My earnings was $23.88, and again, a one-day sale. Not all Lucky Brand shoes do good for me, but this style of boot is just a classic. The leather was super soft, and there was just a beautiful boot all around, a classic minimal style. That's why I knew that they would do good. Same with this next one. Not everything is an automatic pickup, but some styles are fast flippers. It was these Vince Camuto tan leather peep toe block heels. They sold for $25. Earnings there was $20, and they sold in just one day. This style of shoe is a great transitional piece because it's a booty, but it also has the peep toe cut out. So it's great when you're moving from winter to spring and summer, or from spring and summer to fall. I have a lot of these style of booties in my closet right now in all sizes and in all types of brands, and I expect all of them to do well. Okay, now let's move on to some sales that sat around for way too long. And I know I've said this before in other videos, but not always is it a bad thing that items sit around for way too long if the profit is going to be good. None of these apply. All of these, just like the low price category, are something that I would not pick up again. Starting off with an eBay sale. It was these Spurry faux fur lined water resistant slip-on comfort shoes. They sold for $27.98. Earnings was $25.26, and these shoes were listed for a total of 319 days. I'm really starting to realize that shoes that have heavy fur accents, whether it's the insole or fur trim around the top, end up sitting for way too long. I've had many by several brands, and this has always been the case. So I'm thinking people only like fur on their boots, not so much their sneakers. Number 7 is a Poshmark sale, and it was this Clark's Collection Distressed Leather Soft Cushion Western Ankle Boots. They sold for $25. My earnings was $18.28, and these boots were listed for a total of 336 days. I really have no explanation as to why these boots sat around for this long. I've never had any Clark shoes sit for this long, much less boots. And the boots were in great condition. The style was not awful, the size was decent, but they were just not budging. It took a lot of relists, a lot of offers sent to finally get them moving. This next one on Poshmark again is a Matilda Jane open front white nautical hooded cardigan sweater. It sold for $13. My earnings was $8.33, and this sweater was listed for 347 days. This one also took quite a few relists to get it moving, but I do have an explanation for why this one sat around for so long. Mainly it was because it did have a brown like food type stain on one of the pockets, but also because it was a size extra small, and smaller sizes tend to move on the slower end. But overall, Matilda Jane is a good, profitable clothing brand to pick up. So I wouldn't say this is a good representation of how well Matilda Jane can do. I'd say look out for it this summer in their dresses. They always do pretty good. The fifth one is on Poshmark again. It was this Tommy Hilfiger wool blend ribbed pullover bell sleeve varsity crew neck sweater. This one actually sold in a bundle with these Sorel boots and with these Clark boots. The price worked out to be $29.30 for each of those items. Earnings was $23.46. And the Tommy sweater was listed for 347 days. I was so glad to see this sweater in this woman's bundle because I've had it for so long. It was a style-based pickup. I thought it had a lot of things going for it. It was wool blend, it was that waffle knit, the bell sleeves, and it was just a good preppy style. I thought it would do good, but it just kept sitting and sitting. I must have paid like $3 to $4 for this sweater. So because it sold in the bundle, in the end it worked out to be kind of okay. But I was really so ready to let go of this sweater for as low as $10. If someone had sent me that offer, I would have accepted it. Same with this next one too. If someone would have offered me $10, I would have took it. It also sold on Poshmark, and it was this LAL button front collarless dark wash preppy blue jean jacket. It sold for $12. Earnings was $9.05. And this one sat around for even longer, 383 days. Just like the sweater, I picked up this jacket because I thought it was a nice little preppy style that someone would like. And also, it was just $1. I didn't think anything could go wrong with it. I would be able to at least flip it real quick for at least $5-$7 final profit. But no, LAL, which is Live A Little, is not a good brand. And due to that, it sat around for so long. Next one is an eBay sale, and it was the sterling silver amethyst teardrop earrings with a diamond accent heart pendant. It was a set. They sold for $45. The earnings was $35.99. And these here were listed for 558 days. This was a personal item that I did not find myself using that much, so I decided to go ahead and list it. But I had to relist this thing on all three platforms many times and drop the price a lot in order to finally get it sold. But at least the earnings is all profit. Next one on is on Poshmark, and it was this La Blanca swimsuit tie-dye geometric print bathing suit top. It sold for $10. Earnings was $7.05. And this one was listed for 602 days. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm thinking that I picked this up because it was just $1. On Poshmark, I looked at the comps just now, and La Blanca swimwear goes from anywhere from $12 to $15, but it's mostly new with tag stuff, or those that have the set where it has the top and the bottom. This was neither of those, so I think that's why it sat around for so long. As I said, I'm not picking up that much clothing anyway, but if I ever do, this brand would definitely not make the cut. So those were some of the good and bad sales of the month. Now let's discuss the total sales numbers. In total, I made $6,374. Earnings after platform fees, shipping costs, and some discounts was $4,568. And my cost of goods for everything that sold was $1,606. So that left me with a final profit of $2,962. Almost that $3,000 mark, which is where I really want to stay for the rest of the year. I don't know how possible it's going to be, but if I could stay at $3,000 total profit, that would be awesome. Overall, there was a slight decline in the total sales, but being that I wasn't listing as much and I did drop a platform, as we'll talk about here shortly, I think that it ended up being okay. Breaking those sales down by platform, on Poshmark, I made a total of $4,131. On eBay, it was a total of $1,975. That is so close to that $2,000 milestone that I've never reached before, and I really hope that I can get to here within the next few months. I didn't list any new items at all the last 4 to 5 days of January, so I'm sure that I wouldn't have missed those days and I would have listed new things. I would have hit that 2K milestone, but there's always next month. Then we have this platform, which is the one that I stopped listing on, Mercari. I sold a total of $267 there. So that is a huge drop. That is what happens when you stop listing on a platform. I didn't list a single new item there. I did a few relists and dropped some prices here and there, sent out a few offers, but overall I was not doing that much. And I have been mentioning in past videos about how I was kind of irritated with Mercari. Sales were just not picking up. But aside from that, there were a few packages that were either delayed or tracking was just not updating, so my earnings were on hold for longer than normal. It just seems that Mercari is having a lot of issues. I don't know if that's just me, but their app is down sometimes. As I said, tracking is not updating, and they don't really have the structure for us to run a successful reselling business. They don't have a place for a SKU number. You have to do extra things to print your label on a thermal printer. It was just getting very irritating, and being that I wasn't making that many sales over there, it was taking up more time delisting items when they sold on other platforms. So that's why I decided to just go ahead and drop it once and for all. Moving on, let's talk about the inventory and the work that went on to reach those sales numbers. I listed a total of 160 items this month. That makes it to about 5 items a day. That is a total bummer because I had every intention to keep my daily listed items to a solid 7. But other things had to take priority and I just couldn't get it done. But the good thing is that did not affect my overall sales because the item sold is 205. That is just 5 less than last month. And daily sales stayed at about 6 to 7 a day. So that is still pretty good, being that I wasn't listing as much. But maybe I'm going to see the results of that lowered listing count till next month. I hope that's not the case. We shall see, but sometimes that's how it works out. Average selling price for the month was $31.09, and my average cost of goods was $7.84. Both of those numbers stayed pretty average, and I'm happy with those. So overall, that was a pretty good start to the year, but I really don't know what to expect from here, because as many of you know, my husband wasn't working, so I've been having his help for the past month or month and a half. He was helping me out a lot with some of the reselling tasks. That has helped me get ahead a bit, but he has gone back to work, so I won't be having his help as much. So that, and with me being 32 weeks pregnant as of today, February 7th, I have about 5 to 8 weeks to prepare for this baby's arrival, as well as prepare my business so that it can run as efficiently and as best as possible while I'm getting adjusted to having and caring for a newborn. So because of all of that, as I said in the beginning of this video, I am going to have to slow down just a little bit. Once I get situated and adjusted, I can ramp up again and start making strides towards hitting my $8,000 in sales in a month goal that I have this year. So for now, in February, next month, my plan is to focus on getting at least 5 listings a day up every single day. I won't have as much time to go outsourcing, so I really want to spread out the inventory that I do end up getting across multiple days. Instead of listing a lot all at once, I want to make sure that I have enough to list every single day. That's going to keep my stores active and running with new daily listings, even if there's less of them. I feel like that will help maintain some activity in my store overall. The next thing I want to do is finally do an inventory check. This is something that I've been putting off for way too long, and I definitely want to make sure that I get this done before this baby gets here, just so that everything is more organized and there's less mistakes when my son is doing the shipping. And an inventory check just means that I will go through all of the items that I have here in my home, pick out the ones that have been listed for about a year and a half to 2 years, and either lower the price a lot or take them to a consignment shop, or maybe even just redonate them all together. And also, I would just go through everything and make sure that everything I have here in my home is up and listed for sale on my platforms, and that everything that's listed for sale on my platforms, I actually do have in my home. I've done this once before, and you'd be surprised at what ends up slipping through the cracks. I ended up finding lots of items that I had here at home but weren't listed, or items that were listed and up for sale that I didn't have anymore because they sold a long time ago. So that's the benefit of doing an inventory check. You just make sure everything is in order. Another thing I want to focus on is just decluttering and reorganizing my space. I either need to buy some shelves for my inventory, finally, I've been putting that off as well, or I need to build something to make sure that I have enough room for new inventory. I also just want to reorganize furniture around my home and around my workspace to make sure everything's running as efficiently as possible. And I did want to start looking into Depop and start selling there to replace Mercari spots. But after doing some thinking, I decided that it would be a lot more beneficial for me to hold that off for now and instead buckle down on Poshmark and eBay. So that's what I plan to do instead. Just update my Poshmark and eBay store. On eBay, I want to see what I can do to increase my seller level. I also want to test out new coupons and marketing strategies on eBay. On Poshmark as well, as of right now, I do participate in Closet Clear Out every Friday and Sunday, and I also do run bundle sales on all the other days. but I want to see if I can adjust that, make some changes, update the marketing strategies there on Poshmark as well, and just see what other things I can do to attract more sales. So I'll be brainstorming on a lot of that. And as for total sales numbers for the month, my goal is to keep it at about 5,800 to 6,000. Since I am going to be listing a little bit less, I don't know how feasible that is, but with the new marketing efforts and also focusing on relisting, checking my inventory, as I said, and listing anything that I thought was listed but wasn't, I think doing all of that may help me keep my numbers up that high. But we shall see what happens next month. In the comments down below, let me know, how did your 2023 kick off? Was it on a good note, a bad note, or just in between? Let's talk about it down in the comments. Off to the side here, I will leave a playlist with many more of these income reseller reports. If you want to learn more about things that sell and don't sell, go check out that playlist. And that's all for me today. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time.